My name is Astro Teller, and I'm the captain of moonshots at X. You know, I think people over focus on drones plus burritos. I just think that that's sort of missing the point.
Flying burritos could be a thing of the future, really. New video as researchers start testing.
Every time we have, as a society, as a species, removed another big chunk of the friction in how physical things are moved around in the physical world, boats, planes, trains, horses, and the Pony Express, each one of these things has profoundly changed society. It's easy for us to see those things looking backwards because we've become used to not having the frictions that have been removed. We would never go back. But we're very used to the remaining friction in how physical things are moved around in the physical world. If you could just snap your fingers and have something magically appear in your hand whenever you wanted it to, let's say it was no cost and it was instantaneous. You have a hammer in your home. You probably have a power drill. You use it 1/10,000th of the time, maybe 1/100,000th of the time. If that hammer was sitting in some central location, it could be shared by thousands of people really safely, making everybody wealthier functionally because they would get the hammer when they need it without having to pay for the hammer and drain the world's resources by making all of these hammers that go almost entirely unused. If we could move from an ownership society to an access society, where having it now wasn't important, what was important was having it when you need it, it would really dramatically, magically change the world. Now, how is it going to be possible for something to appear just when you want it? Everyone can imagine Harry Potter owl post bringing that hammer to their home, even if they think that drones are unlikely. Well, we certainly can't tolerate things being moved to your home with the carbon footprint and the sound pollution and the traffic congestion and the unsafety level of cars bringing that hammer to your home. Why do you have a 4,000-pound truck that has one single 4-pound piece of food in it coming across town? Surely that factor of 1,000 in weight and cost, it doesn't make any sense at all. We can do better than that. And when we do, we will look backwards and wonder that we ever used to have a time when everyone owned their own hammer. It will just seem bizarre to us. Thank you.